The revision I am recording, so this will be helpful for you to put it in YouTube. Okay. Okay. So we shall go for output equation of transformer. So what are the concepts we have? So we shall study today output equation of transformer. So output. Equation of three-phase transformer. In exam, they may ask single phase or three-phase. So almost they are same. Only thing is small changes are there. We shall discuss that one by one. So output equation of three-phase transformer. It is also one of the important question. You can make a 5-star for this one. It is important question. It is a 5-star. In every question paper, you can see either single phase or three-phase equation. Okay. So for that, first we have to consider this core diagram. This core, it is the three-phase core. It is the three-phase core. So it is the yoke part. We can say three are the limbs. We can say or we can say legs also, you can say the links, limbs or legs. So these are the 1, 2, 3. This is 1, this is 2, the 3. These three are the limbs or legs. And one more thing is that it is complete core, and this part are called as window. So how many window we have in this case? We have 2 windows. This is a first window, this is the second window. In case of three-phase transformer, we have 2 windows. We have the 2 window. And where we are placing the windings? We are placing windings like this. On each limb, we have the primary winding and secondary winding. So like this, we are placing the windings. In this only, we are placing HV and LV. Both windings we are placing on the same limbs. So total there are 3 limbs, 3 windings, 3 phase. So like that we can say, so it for a 3 phase transformer, so we are placing windings like this, and we have the 2 windows. Okay, next move on to the, so we have to consider, what we have to consider? Consider in total induced EMF. We have to consider total induced EMF. So total induced EMF. What is that equation? Total induced EMF equation is equal to, it is E is equal to 4.44 frequency main flux T. Okay, it is induced EMF equation it is. Next. We are writing this induced EMF equation, EMF induced in a primary winding, that's why it is TP. It is EP. So EMF induced in a primary winding writing. So EP is equal to 4.44 frequency, flux and number of turns P. Next, what we require, we say it is equation number 1. Next we need is that EMF per turn we have to calculate. So EMF per turn. So whatever we have got in equation number 1, it is the total induced EMF for all turns of primary. We require only for one turn. How much it is? So it is now to calculate that EMF by TP. It is 4.44 frequency flux and TP divided by TP. So TP will cancel. We'll get 4.44 frequency and flux. So we can say we are writing like this ET. So it is the ET. It is required. At last we require this equation. Correct? It is ET. ET we have. So what is the next thing? Next thing is that area we have to find out. Copper area. Total copper area. In short, I am writing Cu. So total copper area in window. Total copper area in window. So it is called as AC. So AC is equal to, we have done in case of single phase transformer, it is the copper area of primary plus primary winding. Primary means primary winding. Copper area of secondary winding. Copper area of primary winding, copper area of secondary winding, which is in the window, where we have the copper area in primary and secondary, or in case of window, where we have that? Yes, these are the parts. So these are the windings are placed in the window. We are not considering all these parts. Because they are not in window. We are considering only this part. Because these windings are placed in a window. And the sulp area window cover aagta ada. Adun consider madlikidivi ashta. Copper area of primary in window. So next. In next case is that copper area of primary means what it is? It is, we are writing AP and TP. Why we are writing AP and TP here? TP is the number of turns of primary into area of primary winding. Unit area of primary winding we are considering. Next, for the secondary, it is AS and TS. AS means what? Area, unit area of secondary winding into total number of turns in the secondary winding. So that we are considering. So now, for a three phase, what you have to write? For a three phase, it is multiply by 2. Because we have two windows. That's why copper area will be multiplied by 2. That is the change here compared to single phase. So it is now, so current density. Remember, do you remember that current density is equal to what? Current density delta is equal to current by area. So it is the delta. Current density for a primary is IP by AP. And for a secondary, delta is equal to IS by AS. But you have to consider that for this derivation, for calculation of output equation, current density of primary and secondary both should be same. So we have to assume that, current density is same for both winding be same. So like that we have to assume. So what we have got now, I'm writing here. So what we have got? So delta is equal to what? As per this equation, IP by AP is equal to S by AS. So equal. So now, so with respect to this part, we decide, so AP is equal to IP by delta. And with respect, by taking this one, we can write like this also, right? AS is equal to IS by delta. Like this, you can write. So this equation number 3 becomes, what happens now? Equation three becomes So AC is equal to 2 times of into TP. In place of AS, you write this part. In place of AS, we write IS by delta. That's it. IS by delta into TS, which is common now. Delta is common. 2 by delta is common. Write IP TP plus IS TS. Getting this one? Say equation number 4. Now, this much we have got now. In terms of current density, we have written. Next, these two we have to take. What are these two? These are the ampere turns. MMF. These two are a MMF. Ampere turns. So, ampere turns nothing but what? MMF. It is equal to ampere turn. That is equal to I into T. With respect to primary, IP. For secondary, MMF, it is nothing MMF. Take care of MMF here. That is a magnetomotive force. That is a magnetomotive force required to allow the flux to flow. Similar to the voltage. Hang on, electrical circuit. Voltage hang push. The voltage nothing but what? It is a force which allows the current to flow. Current flow in force voltage. Strength voltage. So like that, in core, flux has to flow. To flow the flux, which is giving force? Magnetomotive force is giving the force to flow the flux. So that magnetomotive force, MMF, so it is pushing the flux, but it is depending on what parameter? It is depending on our current parameter. So whatever supply we are giving, that's from that supply, we are getting current. With the help of current, we are getting the MMF. With the help of MMF, flux will flow. That's why MMF and current, we are interlinking here. MMF nothing but what? It is depending on current. Means what? Ampere. It is not only current, current of all windings. Current in all windings, number of turns. So like that, for that purpose, we are replacing MMF by ampere term. We are writing MMF nothing but ampere term. MMF depending on what? Current term. Depending on current and term. That's why. So now we are replacing this IPTP ISTS by AT. So for this derivation, we have to assume MMF of primary and secondary winding are same. So equation number 4 becomes AC is equal to 2 time by delta AT plus AT. It is 2 by delta into 2 times of AT means how much it is? 4 times of AT by delta. 4 times of AT by delta. This much we have got now. What is the next thing? Say it is equation number 5. Space factor. So windows factor, it is nothing but what? It is the ratio of AC by AW. So where we have to write now, what is the AC here? AC nothing but what? AC is equal to KW into AW. What is AC? 480 by delta is equal to Is it visible? Whatever I'm showing here. Okay. So it is Kw into Aw. Kw into Aw. So now, so what is At here? At is equal to Kw Aw delta divided by 4. So it is the At equation. With the help of window space factor, we have got the At equation. Say it is equation number 6. This part is over. Which is left out now? Next part is about the SKV rating. So calculating the KV rating of transformer. So KV rating of transformer is, or it is nothing but transformer, nothing but it is output equation. With the help of output equation, we are finding the KV rating. For that purpose, what we are finding? So we are getting the, we are taking the help of Vp into Ip. So Q, this is called as Q. It is Vp into Ip into the power of minus 3. For a three-phase transformer, it is multiply by 3. That's it. So writing Ep in place of Vp, because this Vp supply Vp, it is the induced EMF. It is the supply, it is the induced. Almost we are assuming both are equal to same, because we are assuming there is no loss. Loss is less, so whatever we are supplying, that much will be induced in the primary side. That's it. Vp equal to Ip, we are assuming. Ip 10 to the power of minus 3. What is the next thing we have to do? We have to do is 3 into Ep by Tp. P by Tp into Tp into Ip. What I have done is that multiply and divide by Tp. That's it. What I have done? Multiply, divide by Tp. That I have done. What I have done? Multiply by, divide by Tp. This much equation. Q is equal to 3 Tp, nothing but Ep by Tp, nothing but what? Ep by Tp, nothing but Et. This is nothing but Et. EMF per turn, it is equation number 2. Here, yes. Ep by Tp is equal to, it is nothing but Et. This equation, equation number 2. This much ampere turn, nothing but Ip into Tp. So we'll get, so it is the At 10 to the power of minus 3. Next, what you have to do is substitute all the values at the equation. 3 into what is Et? 4.44 frequency flux. And At in place of At is Kw by 4 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So you can cancel here. 4 ones are 4 1.1 output equation of transformer. So it is the output equation of transformer. We can write in terms of frequency and output equation also. How to write that? In place of flux, we replace flux by BM into AI. So what is BM? Flux density is equal to what? Flux density equal to flux by area. It is a flux, area is iron area. So flux will be equal to BM into AI. So substitute that, we'll get the Q. It is Q, it is phi. Remember, don't get confused here. It is the Q, it is phi. Flux phi, it is the output equation Q. 3.33 frequency, PM, AI, net iron area, KW, AW, delta 10⁻³. So it is the output equation. Say it is equation number 7. So it is output equation of transformer. At last, what you have to write is that you have to write parameters. You have to write that will be the completion of your derivation. So parameters were. So again, all the things you have to write here. So what are the parameters we are considering? Those parameters. So what is the frequency? Frequency is a frequency that it is the flux, main flux. It is flux density. KW, window space factor, window area AW, net iron area AI, delta is the current density. So all the parameters you have to write. So that will complete your derivation part. It will complete of your derivation part. So what are things we have studied now? So output equation we have studied. So output equation of three phase transformer. So we have considered the used EMF equation. So after that, EMF pattern we have studied. Okay, this much we have studied. So after that, area we have studied, window area we have studied. So that what after that what I have written? That window area in terms of current density we have written, that window area in terms of MMF we have written. So after that, so window space vector we have taken. At last, output rating. So this much is the output equation of transformer.